It's the final few days of the Swedish election campaign. Here in Malmo, in the south of the country, the political parties are out in full force, just like during any election. But this year, the city has become part of a national and even international debate. A recent upsurge in violence has seen people being shot on open streets. And in the background is the issue of migration and what some say are a failure of integration as the reason for the violence. But the local councillor responsible for the city's safety is asking for a bit of perspective.
We have the lowest crime rate since 1996. The crime rate is going down, but of course we have some serious issues with gang-related criminality, and we had some very, very disturbing shootouts between criminals. But then again, the crime that our citizens are most concerned about is bicycle theft.
Most of the shootings have taken place in areas where a higher level of the population has a migration background. Perhaps predictably, the right-wing anti-migration Sweden Democrats seem to have more of an interest in discussing the violence.
I was actually close once. I'd just parked my car and left. About 15 seconds later, there was a shooting. I could hear how the bullets were going through the air and hit a fence behind me. That's how close I've been myself.
This area called Rosengård is often called the most dangerous area of Malmö. It is sometimes even described as a no-go zone. But in the local shopping center, the former Swedish interior minister, who is now the parliamentary group leader for the Social Democratic Party, is meeting voters without any apparent sign of security concern.
I would say that from a police perspective, what people call no-go zones are more of go-go zones for the Swedish police. We have to be more present in these areas to get a safer development. But actually, we don't have no-go zones in the international sense in Sweden.
But still, the area is not without problems. Sigrun Sigrudsson is running projects for young people in this area, and she's asking for more action to integrate people from here into the Swedish society.
We do have problems in Malmo. We have problems with the inclusion of people in society. We have problems with the inclusion of children in schools. We're really bad at integrating people. And then I mean not just migrants, but all people. And we have to improve.
Back in central Malmö, the campaigning continues. But while the violence in the city has become part of a national and international debate, most voters here don't seem too concerned.
Of course there's some violence in certain areas, but not all the time. It can also be quiet in those areas. I feel really safe here in Malmö. I'm really happy here. People are nice. But of course sometimes things happen. I think there's been less violence recently than before. And either way, I always feel safe.
Well, of course, Malmö is neither just a dangerous no-go zone nor just an integration wonderland. Like with many other things, it is something in between. But what is clear is that these shootings that have happened in certain parts of Malmö have become a part of the national debate. And it's thought that this has helped the Sweden Democrats, the nationalistic anti-migration party. But just how much they've gained from this and other similar issues? Well, we'll find out about that on election day.